is the meaning? The ear.
Yeah.
Number 14, ya.
Yeah.
That means
hand.
Hand. Your hand. One hand is ya. Now.
Hava. This also means dawn also.
That another meaning of hava is your whims and false desires. That is also hava, but the spelling little bit different. That hava you
write like that. Like that.
Hava. Okay?
And this hava, that means you know, air, you write like that. Hava.
What about the name hava? Like what about the name?
The name is the other one. It's not this. It's
hava.
Hava.
Oh, Hawa. Hawa. Adam's wife.
Yeah. Yeah. That is the other half. That is this. Hawa.
Okay. So after lava aliya means hand. Now read Al Huruf Shamsiya. No, no. That will be Yadan. Yadan. Two hands. Okay, now Al-Huruf Shamsiya, Ta, the letter Ta, At-Taj. Now pay attention that in all these words you will not pronounce Lam. Lam will be merged into the following letter and you will put the Shadda on that following letter. At-Tajir. What does it mean?
Merging.
The second letter, Sa. At-Tawu.
Close.
That, yeah. So the way the this one that I am very sure. So number three, dal.
Adi.
The rooster. Now number four, dal.
Zahab.
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 Wal fidda.
Go.
Now this is the zahab is noun that means it's gold.
Oh,
the
yeah,
gold, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So how different this thing is, this Zahabo?
That is
the same spelling,
Same spelling, but you will use without Al, you will say Zahaba. Zahab, that means he went. And the master of Zahaba will be Al-Zihab. Al-Zihab, that means going. This word is only Zahab, that means gold.
Gold.
This is a noun, that is a verb. Same spelling.
What is the difference between this and
Zahab? This one?
Zahab.
Zahab. Zahab. Yes.
What is the difference between a Zahab and Lulu?
So, Lulu is pearl. Pearls.
Okay.
The pearls.
Okay.
And Zahab is gold.
Okay.
زين للناس حب الشهوات من النساء والبنين والقناطير المقنطرة من الذهب والفضة
والخيل المسومة.
نعم. That is سورة آل عمران.
What is
فضة? فضة is silver. Silver. الذهب is gold. فضة is silver. Okay. Next. الرجل.
زهرة.
الزهرة. What is زهرة?
Flower.
Like.
Flower. Seen a samak.
Fish.
Nah, fish. Sheen. The sun.
Any difference between a samak and a hoot?
No difference. You can use hoot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses in the Quran hoot. Ka sahib al hoot. Fasbir. كما صبر صاحب الحوت. صاد الصدر. صدر means chest. الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس.
رب اشرح لي صدري.
رب اشرح لي صدري. Very good. Very good. ضاد الضيف. ضيف means the guest.
The guest.
Not the weak.
Guest.
Zaif. No. That is da'if. That means weak. With ayn. There is no ayn here. Da'if is only guest. Hal ataka hadithu da'ifi Ibrahim al-Mukramin. in Surah Dhariyat. Did you know the story of the guest of Ibrahim alayhi salam? One time angels, they came in the form of beautiful men. And Ibrahim alayhi salam did not recognize them as angels. He took them as men. So and Ibrahim alayhi salam was very famous for his hospitality. Not a single day he ate his food by himself. Every time he brought the people to sit with him and to eat with him. That was so much generous Ibrahim alayhi salam. So he took them also as his guest, as a man, and without asking any question that who are you, where are you from, why are you coming, all those questions. First he said, just make yourself comfortable, be at home, feel at home. He went inside, talked to his wife that I have a guest, and what do we have for cooking? So she said that we have a calf, a baby cow. So he slaughtered right away. He asked the wife to cook the meat of that, and when the food was ready, then he brought it. Mm-hmm. When he brought all the food, after all this preparation, these guests, they refused. they refused to eat. Now Ibrahim alayhi salam started having like a fear of them, that what is the matter, why are you not eating? And at that time the Arab custom was that if someone is not eating, that means he is your enemy.
Oh.
He is not your friend. Okay? Those enemies also were honest people. Like this time that they are eating and again. Yes. So then Ibrahim alayhi salam, so then those angels, they explained to him. And they said, don't worry, we are not the human being, that's why we are not eating. We are angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the story goes like that. Okay. Next. Letter Ta is a talib, meaning student. Okay, what is a woman student? How do you say? Next letter Za. It is Zahar, not Zohar. However, you can make Zohar also with the same letter, but over here they say with Fatha of Zahar. What is the meaning?
Back.
The back of our body, Zahar, that means back. So it will be the opposite of Sadr. Sadr was chest, of Zahar is back. Okay, Lam. Al-Lahm. The days of Laham is coming, right? Meat, yes. Okay, Noon. The star. Okay. Now, what I'm thinking that only one exercise is remaining to finish this whole lesson. And since everything is fresh in your mind, according to the rules, so just read it. So what is the exercise? Okay. Let's translate it first, you know that instruction. Because this is third instruction in Arabic. And all these will be repeated most often. So inshallah, once you will understand here, you will keep following. Yes?
How do you say we don't serve?
We don't serve.
Meat.
Okay. نحن لا نستخدم لا نستخدم أو لا نستعمل لا نستعمل we do not serve. Okay. Now, first read the red, word in the red. What is it?
Tamarin.
No, it's not tamarin.
Tamarin.
Tamarin. Tamarin is the jama, plural. Plural of tamarin. So make the difference.
Why is it written as tamarin?
Huh? It's not written like tamreen. Both of them are from
there.
There's alif.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. No.
This one now is tamareen.
Okay. No, I got it. Okay.
You got it? Okay. Let me
show you. Yeah, his book is different.
Okay. So, tamareen is the jama plurals. Okay, now read Iqra'il.
Iqra'il.
Kalimatil Atiya.
Kalimatil Atiya.
Okay, let's translate it.
Read the words.
Following words. Read the following words. Atiya is following. Now. The literal meaning of Atiya is coming. Coming words, yani following words. Okay. Vaktubha.
And write them.
Murayan.
Murayan.
According to. Murayan means according to. Kawaida. Grammar. Grammar, the rules. According to the rules. نطق الحروف القمرية والشمسية. نطق means pronouncing.
Pronunciation of the sun and moon letters.
Yes. Pronunciation of the sun and moon letters. So, Brother Arshad, how do you say the whole thing? How do you translate? Now.
اقرأ الكلمات
آتيا
آتيا واكتبها مراعيا
مراعيا
قواعد نطق الحروف القمرية والشمسية.
Not translated.
Read and write.
No. Here it did not say write.
No, just read the word. Read the word.
Following words.
Read the following words and write
according to.
And write them.
Write them.
Okay, how we are getting the translation of them? What is the word over?
Ha.
Ha. Very good. Ha is pronoun. And write them. Yes.
Murayan. Murayan.
According to?
According to the rules. Not
rule and
pronunciation of words. Al-Qamariya, the moon letters.
Letters.
And?
Sun and moon
letters.
Huh? Moon and sun. Yes. Now, read. Okay, one person. Brother Noman, you read. The first one.
Al-Bayt.
Al-Bayt. Okay. No, hold on. We have one person. I want to see that you got that rule. Everyone. Yes. How do we read the next one? Al-Deek or?
Ad-Deek.
Yes. Why? Because the letter Dal is a Shamsi letter. Yes. Next, Brother Arshad.
Al-Mudarris.
Al-Mudarris. Very good. So it means that Meem is a Qamari letter. Brother Kanishka.
Al-Bab.
So is it Shamsi or Qamari?
Qamari.
Qamari.
You cannot actually pronounce Shamsi with L. It's just a tongue twister if you do
that. Because mashallah you are already familiar. But for a beginner it will be hard in the beginning. Yes.
At-Talib,
very good. Next.
As-Sukkar.
Sukkar. As-Sukkar, very good. Next.
At-Daftar,
very good. Next, Brother Hassan. Al-Akh. So here again Hamza, that is a Qamari letter.
What is Allah?
Al-Akh, the brother. The brother.
Oh,
Akhi.
Brother.
Yes.
My brother.
The brother.
Oh, no, I mean, but I say
Akhi means my brother. Yes.
Ar-Rasul.
Ar-Rasul. Okay, the messenger. Okay, now moving forward to sister. Al-Wajh. Wajh means?
The face.
The face. Al-Wajh. Next. Sadiq. As-Sadiq, meaning?
Friend.
The friend. Sadiq is friend.
Isn't Sadiq also truthful?
That is Siddiq.
That's with.
That is Siddiq or Sadiq, not Sadiq.
But same letters? But
same letters, but the pronunciation is totally different. Okay.
What is Ad-Daftar? Is that a book?
Daftar is notebook, yes. All the notebook that you are writing your notes, that is called Ad-Daftar. It's not Urdu Daftar. Okay, next. Sister. Al-Quran, yes. As-Salah. So here, Salah, Saad is Shamsi letter. Yes, sister. Al-Ka'ba. Ka'batullah. The house of Allah. Al-Kaaba. Next. Ar-Ras. Head. Ar-Ras. Ras means? Head.
A Rais.
Yeah, Rais is also pronoun. Okay, next. An Isba. What does it mean? Finger. Isba is finger. And do you know the jama, plural of isba? Asabi'. Asabi'. Yaj'aluna asabi'ahum fi adhanihim. Allah SWT says, Surah Al-Baqarah. Munafiqeen. They put their fingers into their ears. Yaj'aluna asabi'ahum fi adhanihim min as-sawa'iqi hadhar al-mawt.
Asabi'ahum.
And next word, sister? As-sabun. What do you think the meaning?
Soap.
So when we wash soap, yeah, sabun. Okay, next. Brother Omar.
Al-Dhufr.
Al-Dhufr.
I don't know.
Anyone knows the meaning? Nails. Al-Dhufr. Next, Brother Islam?
Al-Fajr.
Everyone knows Al-Fajr, right? Next?
Al-Dhuhr.
Okay, very good.
Al-Asr.
Okay.
Al-Maghrib.
Al-Isha.
See? Yes. So, in other ways, this is the way I like it from this book. You know, they reminded all the five prayers. By Shamsi letters, some of them are with Shamsi letters, some of them are with Tamari letters. Now,
all of them have a meaning, like Al-Fajr is the word.
Names of the prayers, yeah, they have the meanings.
Morning.
Okay, morning Al-Fajr, that is dawn time, it is not subuh. Al-Fajr is daybreak before sunrise. So that is a literal meaning of Fajr. And the name of the Fajr prayer is because we pray it before sunrise, at the dawn time. Then Dhuhr is after Zawal time, when the sun started declining to the west. That is Dhuhr, literal meaning of Dhuhr. And Al-Asr, the literal meaning of Asr is like extract of something, juice of something. So this time of Asr is the extract of the whole day. Okay? When you are started, you know, wrapping up the things. Al-Asr. So that's why it is called Al-Asr. And Al-Maghrib, it's from Ghurub. Ghurub means setting the sun.
The sun is setting down.
Yes. And Al-Isha, that is the evening time. So we learned the word for lunch, that was Al-Ghada. And we have the dinner, the word for dinner, that is called?
Al-Asha,
not Risha. So Risha with Kasra will be prayer, Salatul Risha. With the Fatha, Asha is dinner.
And what is Subuh? Subuh and Fajr, what is it?
Okay, Subuh is morning. So morning included both timings. From the early morning time and when it is actually subah, when you have a brightness. So very close to the sunrise time and after sunrise, that is all is subah. But Al-Fajr is specifically before sunrise.
Okay.
So this is the difference.
So then Al-Isha is what?
Evening time.
Evening
time.
Not night.
No, not night. So Alhamdulillah, we completed this Ad-Dars al-Thalith today. So, as to summarize this whole lesson of today, what did we learn today? Just give me, we learned three things. So, tell me one by one all these three things. Okay, Al-Ghuruf Al-Qamariya Wal-Ghuruf Al-Shamsiya. Next thing. So actually the topic was the definite article Al. That was the main topic of today. And all these things, Shamsi letter, Qamari letter, they come under this topic. Okay. So we learned about the definite article Al in Arabic. and then Huruf Shamsiya and Qamariya. Can someone tell me the hint for sun letters? When you pronounce, what happens? The tip of the tongue is involved in the pronunciation of those letters and the blade of the tongue. And Qamari letters? They are not And some other point that we learned after this.
The opposites.
Opposite of the words. Okay, that was vocabulary section. Okay. But again, on the topic of Al, what did we learn? Husla. Hamzatul Wasl. When Alif is dropped in the pronunciation, but still it will be written. And the Husla sign will be?
Swar. So if you have a Husla in a Shamsi letter, you will not pronounce the Alif and the and Lam.
Yes, you do not pronounce both of them, Alif or Lam, because Lam will be merged into the following letter. But you will pronounce that letter with the Shadda.
The Shadda.
Yes.
Vashams.
Yes, very good. So these are the things that we learned today, and we did a good exercise, mashallah. So we translated so many sentences. So, and the homework you will be getting for writing.
Hamzatul Qata.
And then one thing is Hamzatul Qata. We learned about Hamzatul Qata. Yes. So,
what's the homework?
Homework, writing those sentences. At least five. If you can write more, you can write more. But at least five sentences. Okay. Tell me about next Sunday. Next Sunday is the third day of Eid al-Adha. Are you planning to come, inshallah?
Yes, inshallah.
Okay. How many yes, how many no? Then we will decide. Raise your hand for no.
Take a break, man.
Take a break? You haven't made 2 days.
Okay, so majority says yes. So we have, inshallah, we will meet next Sunday. Same time. And
we're already meeting once a week.
Think about it.
Once a week.
That's right, but that will be the end of the third day.
Yeah, he did it.
Okay.
I didn't have anyone's email address, so I sent it to the Yahoo.
Not next Sunday, the following Sunday, from number 4.
But I'll send it recently. I got the emails now.
Okay.
Yeah.
If anyone cannot make it, because I know that is also family day. Actually, we are still in the beginning, so that's why there is no need. But whatever, and also whatever we will learn the new thing, we will put on the video, so inshallah you will get it.
Yeah.
But that will be excuse, you know, for just next Sunday, because of the Eid. After that, you know, attendance is required.
So we will have a class next week or not?
Yes, we have. Now, in Arabic, naam.
The whole one. What's that? From last week.
Okay, we are approaching to the Maghrib Salah, but let me share with you the sentences. I gave you the...
My homework is on the same sheet that I didn't put on a separate paper.
So next time, inshallah, give me the second.
You have a copy there? Or do you have a fax machine there?
Okay.
Maybe that was next to the office.
What?
What's
Quran
ayah?
Okay. 6:49, I think the Maghrib Salah.
Sunset. You have to go to the Yahoo website.
So I will check your homework with Hada and Dalik, whatever you did, and then I will bring it next Sunday.
Sure.
So then keep this one because I already checked this.
Could you send my name here?
Yeah, your please.
And we need to wrap up the table.